And we're back. Right, we're here in Vegas. We're on the Strip, to be precise. Having a bit of R&R, some downtime. Just chilling out. After the death of Randall, our employer and friend, we avenged him by killing the judge. And afterwards felt like, well, we needed a vacation. Me, Eddie and Cass needed to just put the feet up, relax and recuperate. So we spent some time in Good Springs, drinking, eating, watching the sunsets, getting mindlessly bored, and then decided to go on a road trip. We took a road trip to the most obvious place, the Vegas Strip, where we could enjoy ourselves a little bit more, and in an exciting fashion. We did a few things on the way. For example, did a little bit of shopping, and I found the last mod for my shotgun. Look how cool it looks. It's the one that adds 50% condition to the gun, but it also adds that very cool kind of motif on the side, so that's nice. I mean, the actual conditions, neither here nor there. I'm a gunsmith, I can repair things so easily, I don't care about that, but it looks a little nicer, and that's always good. What else happened? We heard a rumor of a new bounty hunters organization. Well, actually, it's the NCR, I believe. They are now offering bounties directly, and they are working outside of Boulder City. So, when I get time, I'm going to swing round there and pick up some bounties, earn a little bit more money. It's been a while since we've hunted someone down, and kind of miss it. I also received a note from somebody in Novak, somebody who wants me to deliver a package for them, and it was quite an enticing offer, so we're going to go to Novak. In fact, I think that is going to be my next thing. Well, second to next thing to do. Before I do that, before I go running off on jobs, I am going to go and have a quick word with the man in the lucky 38, Mr. House. He has invited me up to chat to him, and he does own the Strip. And I suppose, technically, he also is the boss of Victor over there. And Victor did dig me up. So I suppose I owe him a little bit. So we're going to go and talk to Mr. House first, say hi, see what he wants. And then we're going to go off to Novak and see about delivering this package. And again, getting back on track to earning huge amounts of money. Oh! And, yeah, Benny. Benny's in a casino over there. We should go and basically shoot him, shouldn't we? Yeah, I know. It's funny. I still don't have any anger towards Benny. I can't help it. I guess it's because when he shot me, he was also polite. He was very polite and respectful about it, which, you know, you could argue that being shot in the face was disrespectful, but I can sort of see why people shoot people in the face, and he was respectful. I find it hard to hate him. I am going to go and shoot him anyway, but, you know, still. Anyway, Victor, hello, here to see your boss.
Howdy, partner. Good to see you again. Boss is waiting for you upstairs, so get a move on.
Okay, I'm not totally sure I liked the tone there. Get a move on. I'm not really... Fine, thank you, Victor.
I see you brought some friends.
Yeah?
Sorry, partner. But they're gonna have to stay outside.
Okay, that's a little... No problem, I'll head up. No deal. I go where I... Fine, I guess if this guy wanted me dead, I'd be dead, or I'd still be buried, I suppose.
Come back soon now.
Not if I can possibly help it. Alright, guys. Just hang around out here, and we'll find out what this person wants. Alright. No one's been in here for a long time. Okay. An empty casino. Well, obviously, if no one's been in there, I guess it's going to be empty, apart from securitons. All the lights are on, though. Isn't that a bit of a waste of power? I mean, why have all of these neon lights on? Okay, what was that sound? Alright, we have a haunted casino. It's very clean, isn't it? he says, looking for things to steal. Actually, why don't you let people in? You could make a fortune with this place. It's cleanish. Seriously, you kept the lights on, but you didn't get someone to come in and do some basic repairs. My God, what is it with the people of this place? Oh, hello. No. So, lots of cigarettes. Ooh. Cigarettes, alcohol, and not a lot else. It's a bit dingy. Staying on the ceiling. Worrying? That sound is a little strange as well. Kind of depressing and, I don't know, echoey? Okay. We have a door. Door two. All right, this is the... Oh, you guys got any... Got that sound again. Pre-war money. Apparently they don't care. Fine. Double fine. That sound is weird. You know what it's like? I feel like I've accidentally walked into a whale. Sounds like a whale, doesn't it? It's like a whale's talking and you happen to just be inside its stomach. I feel like Jonah. Yes, I'm well aware of the fact that it wasn't a whale because it was a giant fish and whales aren't fish. He says, continuing to loot the place. But well, no one seems to care. Magnum revolver. Don't need the revolver. Why not? Apparently no one's using anything here. Okay. It's just very, very creepy, okay? It really is very, very creepy. Okay, so... Nice casino. Really, really, really can't believe you're not trying to make any money on this place. So... How did you get in here? You were out there, I came in the door and... Are there two of you? Companion dismissal terminal. Okay.
Where to, partner?
The boss! The penthouse, I guess. I will go to the penthouse.
Penthouse floor.
Yeah, whoa, that is bright. Okay. Hello. Jane, me...
Well, hello, sugar. Mr. House is waiting for you in his office.
Okay. Well, yeah, okay, we'll talk later, maybe. Because that's not strange. It's very bright here. Security on.
Come over and introduce yourself.
Is that Mr. House? Alright. I'm assuming you are the man.
I invited you here so we could talk, not so you can nose around.
Well, I'm here! Talk then! Do I have to get closer? What, are we supposed to get cozy? Fine.
This meeting has been a long time coming, hasn't it?
You've I was come a long busy! Way, stop literally complaining.
And, I suspect, figuratively as well. I have to ask, now that you've reached your destination, what do you make of what you see?
Well, honestly, the first thing that comes springing to mind is... Why is there a thumbprint the size of, well, a beach ball on your screen. Who the hell else is living here, and how do you get them in and out the door if they've got thumbs that big? And that's assuming it's a thumb. It could be their little finger, I suppose. It could be even bigger. I've never seen anything like this place. Kind of true. City devoted to vice and sin, what's not to love? Okay. I prefer the wasteland, to be honest. I'm not totally sure about that. What the hell are you? Perhaps a little on the rude side. Okay. He's gone. Hello? Okay, I've never seen anything like this place. Come back.
Of course you haven't. You Vegas always was one of a kind. What you see down on the strip is just a fraction of the city's former glory, and yet, more than an echo, I preserved its spirit. Or perhaps you were referring to the Lucky 38? The years haven't been kind to her, but still she manages to impress.
That's one word. Why the VIP treatment? I'm just a courier. Yes, that's sort of the million-dollar question, isn't it?
Oh, don't be coy. You've been playing a high-stakes game ever since Victor dug you out of the ground. Don't be afraid to admit it.
Okay, yeah, I've made a few waves. Let's get down to business then, yeah. What do you want?
The business is this. One of my employees has stolen an item of extraordinary value from me, and I want it recovered.
Okay.
Simple enough.
Do you want me to shoot the person as well? Because that's usually what happens. So, fine, go on. What do you propose?
My only concern is the recovery of the platinum chip. What happens to Benny, I leave to your discretion.
The platinum chip.
When you bring the chip to me, I will pay you 4 times the delivery bonus stipulated in your contract. How's that?
Oh. So, the chip thing, the thing that Benny took from me is yours, and I was supposed to deliver it to you, and you want me to... Yeah, I guess I'm already obliged to do that. I agreed to deliver it, didn't I? Apparently I can barter, though. Apparently I can barter. That seems a little rude. That does seem a trifle rude, to be honest. He already contracted me to deliver this, and I failed to deliver it. It just seems rude to barter over it right about now. I mean, 1,000 caps apparently is 4 times more than he was going to pay me to start with. But to be honest with me, with you, you didn't actually tell me or tell the delivery firm how dangerous it was going to be. Okay, seriously, fine, I'll accept. Come back.
Well enough. Return to me when you have the platinum chip in your possession. Any final matters for us to discuss?
Yes, I have some questions, apparently.
What did you wish to know?
How do I get to Benny? That seems to be the million-dollar one, obviously.
It won't be easy. Benny is always surrounded by at least 4 bodyguards, except when he's in his private suite on the 13th floor of the Tops.
Okay, so he's got a private suite, we sneak in there, we shoot him, and he won't have any bodyguards. Say I want a diplomatic approach. Probably not, but let's just say.
If you were to approach Benny in public, you might be able to leverage his fear of exposure to make him agree to meet with you in private.
Okay. The chairman are your employees, are they? Okay, apparently they are. Don't they take orders?
It's more complicated than that. The chairman share what you might call a tribal affinity. Look for a man named Swank, Benny's second in command. He's always been a reliable, if unimaginative, employee. Do your best to convince him that you're working under my auspices. If you have evidence of Benny's crimes, show it to him.
Okay. Why can't you be the one to tell Swank? Good question again.
By contract, Securitrons are to enter the casinos only when invited by the 3 families, or if other extraordinary circumstances arise. The moment I send one into the Tops, Benny will know I'm on to him.
Well, why not send someone who's not a Securitron? I mean, Manchu, I suppose that's what exactly what you're doing right now, isn't it? I suppose that's me. Yeah, okay, fair enough. Any ideas how I could catch him off guard? I like that question.
Sneaking into Benny's suite on the 13th floor would be very difficult, but not impossible.
Stealth boys.
There might be guards. Certainly there'd be a sturdy lock on his front door.
Locks, not a problem. Let's talk about something else, apparently.
What else did you want to know?
Quite a lot, actually. Tell me about Benny. Yes. I mean, what's his star sign, for example?
Benny has led the chairman ever since I recruited his tribe 7 years ago. Until his recent misbehavior, I planned to make him my protege. Maybe if I'd begun grooming him sooner, none of this would have happened.
2020 hindsight. What use would you have for a protege?
To achieve my aims, I require a capable human agent to perform certain tasks.
So you're not human, then?
I knew Benny was ambitious, even ruthless, but I believed he would do the job so long as he was incentivized appropriately. Obviously, I miscalculated his drive for supremacy. But in any case, you've come along. A more than suitable replacement.
Thanks? Why did Benny betray you?
I have to think that he found out about the Platinum Chip and mistakenly convinced himself that he could use it to his own ends. One of the problems of a tribal workforce, I'm afraid. No intuitive understanding of how complex technologies can be.
Yeah, the chip. That's really what it's all about, isn't it? So what is that chip all about? But let's just ask that question first. Why didn't you intervene sooner when Benny ambushed me? Yeah, you! Why didn't you stop him from actually shooting me?
Why didn't Victor intervene sooner, you mean?
Yeah, you, Victor.
Good Springs is a bit too far away for me to reliably control a Securitron agent by remote. I can send and receive packets of data at best. Victor's combat algorithms determine the proper course of action. Benny and his thugs were more than a match for a lone Securitron.
Oh, really?
When he alerted me, I instructed him to approach the site after Benny and the others had departed.
Oh, okay. These Securitons, they look kind of tough. They look like they could take tribals without any trouble whatsoever. Let's talk about something else.
What else did you want to know?
Platinum chip. Yeah, what is it you had me carrying that got me shot in the head and now you want me to get back?
It's a very special item. There's nothing else like it in the entire world. It was lost a long time and difficult to find. That's all you need to know about it for this stage of our enterprise. Fulfill your contract, deliver the chip, and good things will come your way.
Okay, that sounded... The less I know, the less I care. What do I need? No. I have a right to know more. Do I? He's paid me for a job. If the chips are valuable, why use a single courier to transport it? That's a good question.
You realize you were just one of many couriers. The rest of them, dummies, so to speak.
Yeah, okay.
Add to that, many thousands of caps worth of mercenary protection to screen your avenue of approach. Had I used an armed caravan to transport the chip, I might as well have been announcing to the world, "This is important! Attack this!"
That's
I didn't
fair
want
enough.
To attract the attention of groups like the Great Khans or the Brotherhood of Steel. Alas, the real threat was closer to home.
Yeah, okay. Why don't you send your robots into the tops to arrest Benny? Probably the same reason he didn't send a robot in to talk to Swank. Although, no, his reason for sending him in to talk to Swank was it would tip Benny off. Send the robots in, just arrest Benny. Go on then.
Frontal assaults on casinos? Not good for business.
Very good.
In any case, Benny would see it coming, and all he'd have to do is hold the chip up and point a pistol at it. Our foremost advantage is that Benny doesn't know that I know he has the chip. Let's not squander it.
No, that's fair enough. Okay, anything else?
What else did you want to know?
Who exactly are you, Mr. House? That's an exceptionally good question.
I am Robert Edwin House, President, CEO, and sole proprietor of the New Vegas Strip. I oversaw the city's renovations starting from 2274 onward. The three families are my employees. Before the Great War of 2077, I was the founder, president, and CEO of Robco Industries, a vast computer and robotics corporation.
You appear to be a computer, not a man. That seems a little personal, doesn't it? How did you establish New Vegas?
We can discuss this in greater detail at another time. Suffice it to say that when my Securitrons detected NCR scouts at Hoover Dam, I took action. I recruited a tribal force to supplement my Securitrons and renovated the strip just in time to welcome the NCR as it marched into the region. Instead of war, a treaty was negotiated, and the money started to pour in.
Okay, yeah, you appear to be a computer, not a man.
Don't let the video screens and computer terminals fool you. I'm flesh and blood, not silicon.
All right. The lifespan you're claiming is impossible except for ghouls and supervillains. Why do I need medicine skill of 35 to do that? I mean, he set up, what was it? He was there alive before the war, which was 2070-something, and he started renovating the strip. Basically, he's about 300 years old. Why do I need medicine skill of 35 to point that out?
I see you've made a study of the topic.
What? A study of the topic to know that people don't live to 300?
Perhaps after a decade or two of economic reconstruction, I can commercialize these technologies and offer them to others, such as yourself.
Okay, that was an offer of immortality, wasn't it? Sort of. Or longevity. Okay, interesting. How have you stayed alive all this time? Yes, give me the details.
Let's just say it was very costly.
I have a lot of money.
But I was willing to make the sacrifices longevity entailed, financial and otherwise.
Otherwise? Okay, that sounds a little ominous.
What else did you want to know?
Tell me about the factions vying for New Vegas. Go on then.
It's understandable that you'd be curious about this topic. But we'll hold off until the platinum chip has been recovered.
Okay.
What else did you want to know?
Apparently nothing else. Goodbye.
Well enough. Be on your way.
Okay. I have to tell you, I'm not that keen on the way you're talking to me. Okay. So, we've basically got a job to go and,
Welcome to the Vegas Strip.
Thank you. You. Creepy robot. Victor! Elevator door. No. Victor!
Congratulations, partner. The boss has instructed me to comp you to the high roller suite. You can bring your friends, too. Be like a little clubhouse for the gang you put together.
Okay.
Just bear in mind, you're the only one gets to see the boss. Any friends you got, they can wait in the suite. Enjoy the digs, partner. They're plenty fancy.
Oh, they're fancy. Okay, take me to the presidential suite.
High roller suite.
Okay. You said this was fancy. Let me tell you what it is. Oh, okay, that's not too bad. Oh, today's physician. Physician? Physician. Defaced ranger helmet and defaced ranger combat armor. Okay, really? Defaced with what? We shall have a look. Some glasses. Eyeglasses. This is not exactly what I would call fancy, Victor. However, it does have another advantage. Hello? Oops. We need a maid to clean that up. I can use it as a clubhouse. For the guys! And I believe now I can actually use my house in Good Springs as a clubhouse as well. All right, it's okay. Oh, I'll tell you what, before we go anywhere, let's have a look. Items. Apparel. Defaced combat armor and ranger helmet. Let's take the flashlight off for now. All right. That isn't a very polite thing to say, is it? And what does it say on the helmet? Can I get light on it? A? What? A. Okay, for... Oh god, it's got a crack in the, I'll tell you what, though. It's kind of cool-looking armor. Look at the legs. The legs are pretty cool. Alright. So, let's have a look at this. The Ranger helmet, yeah. Authority glasses. Let's put my brown hat on again. And my flashlight belt. What is the defaced armor? DT-14. What? Alright, the belt doesn't work with it. The flashlight belt doesn't work with it. It depends on how you define work, I suppose. Okay, we're back. I'm going to leave that here. I have no need for defaced armor that disappears when I put a belt on it. Here you go. That was weird, wasn't it? Okay, let's go and pick up.
Where to, partner?
Casino cocktail lounge. Just show me the cocktail. Okay, that is bright. Okay, so we got a cocktail lounge that's not quite as dingy as the main casino, which is. Okay. Snow globe test site. You found a limited edition Mojave landmark snow globe cash register. Well. Scotch. Okay. And casino. So now, I can bring the guys in here. Which is actually very, very, very cool. You know what we should do? We should go and swing by and pick up Veronica and send her over.
Hey, you there. I have a message for you.
Okay.
It's from Ambassador Crocker. Very important.
Okay.
There you go.
No added. Ambassador Crocker. Yeah. Data. Miscellaneous. I wish to speak with you immediately in regards to important matters. I trust you have learned enough in your travels to know that the New California Republic is an honorable nation engaged in a beneficent mission in the Mojave in general and New Vegas in particular. It is in addition a wealthy nation that well rewards persons who dedicate themselves to its national interests, whether for reasons patriotic or material. Hello, I am listening. Allow me to reassure you that if you have committed any crimes or misdemeanors against the Republic, it is in my power to pardon misconduct of this sort. Well, no, I'm the NCR, they kind of love me. I stand ready to receive you at your earliest convenience in my offices at the New California Republic Embassy at the south side of the Vegas Strip. God bless the New California Republic, Dennis Crocker, Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary, Department of State, New California Republic. Okay. Well, all of a sudden, I seem to be very... popular. Accepted! Folks have come to accept you for your helpful nature. Really? I walk into the casino and everyone loves me. This place is weird. Wait here, nope.
Let's hit the
Follow
road.
Me. Right. So, here's the deal, guys. Before we head off out of here and pick up that package we're supposed to deliver. I have agreed to... Where has it gone? Bring the platinum chip to Mr. House. We should do that. And we should also, actually... The new... Speak to Captain Larry Skull about require... No, I haven't. Where's... Didn't I just get a quest to go and see the NCR ambassador? Apparently not. Interesting. Alright, well, for now, we're off to... The Tops. Okay. Just walk on in, I guess. And... They're probably going to want my guns.
Yep. Hey, fella, welcome to the Tops Hotel and Casino. I'm going to have to ask you to hand over any weapons you might be carrying.
Keep holdout weapons. Why do you need my guns? I... Five words. From my cold, dead hands. I think not. Sure, here we go. Keeping holdout weapons.
Smooth and easy, just the way I like it. Don't worry, they'll be as safe as kittens till you're ready to leave.
They better have
been. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. If you happen to stumble across any weapons during your stay here, well, just don't wear them openly. You dig? Now that we got that little business out of the way, what can I do to make your Tops experience the Tops?
Where did you take my weapons? And I'm going to point out, those weapons' combined value is probably about half the value of this entire casino, okay? Those are some serious, serious weapons.
Relax, baby. The safe is houses. We'll keep them locked up in the bank upstairs right next to the money. It's serious protection.
Okay. What is it? What is there to do here?
Everything your little heart desires, that's what. You like gambling? Boom. Either one of the main hallways has cards, slots, you name it. Hungry? Thirsty? The restaurant just off the left-hand hallway has the best food and booze in Vegas.
Okay.
Or maybe you'd rather take in a show. The Aces Theater upstairs always has hot acts raring to go. Check it out.
Aces Theater upstairs. Thank you.
Have a good time, baby.
I will. I'd like to find out what weapons I've got.
Hello?
Is there a private little space I can just... No, not really. Let's just be careful not to take the weapons out. Let's just have a look at what we've got. We managed to keep a Magnum revolver. Nice. We've got the Lil Devil. We got the pulse gun. How the hell did they not notice that? Magnum revolver. So they spotted my sweet vengeance. They spotted my hand axe, but they didn't spot the Lil Devil. So I tell you what. Let's just put that on the hotkey. I think that thing's probably better than the revolver. Yes, and it was, of course, silent. And it has a laser sight. Okay, good. Question. Okay, so they don't show up. I did... I haven't got it selected. What happens if I select it? It shows up on my person. That would probably get me killed, wouldn't it? Let's not do that. Let's not do that. Right. So, step one, find Swank.
Hey, there's the high roller.
I'm looking for Swank. Swank! That's a very unfortunate name now I come to think about it.
Hey, you baby. Good to see you. Always nice to have a celebrity drop by.
What? I'm a celebrity? Okay. Who are you?
Ain't been on the strip long, have you, pal? Name's Swank. This is my joint.
All right. I thought Benny ran the place.
Benny oversees the business, sure, but I run the Tops day to day. I'm his right-hand guy, you dig?
Okay. I'm looking to make a few extra caps. Got any jobs you need done, he says, trying to be casual.
You might have a jaw at Tommy Torini up in the Aces. He's always looking for talent scouts.
Okay, can you give me the rundown on Vegas? Nice place you got there. Oh, by the way, there's something you might want to know about Benny. There you go.
Really? You got something to say about the big boss, huh? Well, why don't you say it to his face instead of yapping at me?
Speech 15. I don't think you're going to like it. Seems Benny's been making his own play. Yeah, come on. We need this guy on our side.
Huh? What are you talking about?
I got more evidence that proves Benny tried to kill me.
Yeah? What else you got?
I found these cigarette butts by the grave he... Really? That's right. I got evidence that he tried to kill me. Here's some cigarette butts.
Huh. Well, yeah, okay. These are Benny's brand, and they ain't too common. You got anything else?
That's it. That, I'm afraid, is it. Yeah, right.
I think you might just be onto something here, kid. Tell you what. I can't actively back your play, but I'll keep the chairman off your back. I'll tell the doorman you're cool to pack heat inside. Trust me,
ooh,
you're gonna need it.
Can I get my guns back?
You'll still have to deal with Benny's private goon squad, though. I got no play with those cats. You want more help? I'll need more proof.
Oh, okay, goodbye. You've received your confiscated equipment.
Kid.
Does that mean I can pull the weapons out? Just really? No, well, maybe not. The best idea. I'm just gonna... Oh, she's got a weapon back. Okay, right. So, apparently we can. Right, let's have a look. Anti-material rifle. Lever action shot. Hello, I've missed you. Little devil. I'm going to keep the little devil, actually, on the hotkey. Sweet revenge. Missed you, too. Medicine stick. Paciencia. And I think that was it. I think that's it. I think, yeah, everything is now hotkey. I really want to check it. I want to pull my weapons out, but I'm not sure whether that's a good idea still. I know he says I can have my stuff back, but probably taking it out and waving it is really, really daft. Okay, so we've got a casino. This looks rather... See, this looks nice. This looks pleasant. This looks kind of clean. It's... Yeah. A few repairs might not be amiss, but... It's bright. It's nice. Oh. Okay, seriously, come on! Oh, God. And I was busy being impressed. What have we got here? Elevator inaccessible. Elevator inaccessible. Elevator inaccessible. Take elevator to 13th floor. That's where Benny's room is. We can go find Benny. Elevator. Anything else? A lot of inaccessible elevators here, except the one. Right, and what have we got here? So the courtyard. This place has a courtyard. And we crash. Okay, it looks like we're not going out there. Nope. we'll have to figure out what's going on there another time. Right, so... This is the elevator to the 13th floor. Now, he's got a suite up there. Can we just go up there? It doesn't look like... Okay, no one's... Okay, that would be stealing. Open door locked. Open door locked. Okay. And that would be considered a bit of a crime, apparently. Okay, that looks kind of like a big suite, doesn't it? Hello, boys. How are you doing? All right, so just a single corridor, two guys. All right, guys, I want you to all stay right about here.
All right.
I'm going to look inconspicuous and... I'm out of sight. Let's have a look. Okay. Okay. Is he coming? Oh. Can I get out? All right. So is this Benny's suite? The only suite up here, so I'm guessing so. Do we have a Benny? right. Nope. Okay. So, hi, and you are the Yes Man. Okay, that's very strange. All right, what's your story?
Hey! Hi there! Good to meet you. What can I do for you today?
Have you seen Benny?
He was around here not too long ago. He's probably down on the casino floor now. You can wait for him here if you like. I'm incapable of asking you to leave.
Kim, what are you doing here?
Good question. My function is to monitor Mr. House's data network and decode his encrypted transmissions.
Okay.
Allow me to introduce myself. I'm a PDQ-88B Securitron, but you can call me Yes Man.
I'm going to call you something ruder than that, very probably. Yes Man, what kind of name is that? Shouldn't you be working for Mr. House? How the hell did you end up here?
As I understand it, I used to be just like all those other Securitrons out on the strip. But then my neurocomputational matrix was completely reprogrammed to be nice!
Okay.
Very, very nice!
That sounds annoying. Benny reprogrammed a Securitron all by himself?
Oh, he had some help. A lady friend of his. She said something about living in a fort over in Freeside. But that's all I remember.
Ah, the Mormon fort. Okay, Benny stole a platinum... What is this place? Before I start telling him.
This is Benny's workshop. When the tops got renovated, he had this half of the floor blocked off for his own use. I guess you could say it's my entire world. I don't think I've ever left this room, but that's okay. I'm not complaining.
Okay. Benny stole a platinum chip from me. Do you know what it's for?
Sure. Benny had me look at it a bunch of times.
Do you have it?
It's a data storage device, kind of like a holotape, but a lot more advanced. As for what's on it, well, some of Mr. House's data transmissions made it sound like the chip could upgrade his defenses somehow. That's just a guess, though. The chip's a proprietary format. You need special hardware to read the data on it. There are two locations with non-standard hardware on the network. The Lucky 38 and an underground facility at Fortification Hill. I'd look there!
Okay, map marker I did. What's Benny planning to do with the chip? I think take over the world?
Oh! He wants to kill Mr. House and use the platinum chip to copy my neurocomputational matrix onto the Lucky 38's mainframe. That should give me control over all Mr. House's defenses. Most prominently, his Securitrons. And then I just do what Benny tells me.
So right.
Easy peasy.
Take over the world. Got it. You're very forthcoming with that information. Sort of, yeah?
I was programmed to be helpful and answer any questions I was asked. I guess nobody bothered to restrict who I answer questions for. That was probably pretty dumb, huh?
Just a little bit, yes. What happens if I want to take over New Vegas instead of Benny?
Then I'd have to help you. I mean, it seems pretty obvious Benny wouldn't want me to, but hey, not my fault I can't say no.
Okay, what are the details of the plan?
Again, goal number one is to eliminate Mr. House and install my neurocomputational matrix on the Lucky 38's mainframe. Given how you're a new arrival, I also recommend that you get to know some of the region's tribes, so you can decide how you feel about them. By the time you finished up all of that, the Legion should be close to attacking Hoover Dam, and we'll execute the last phase of the plan.
You know what?
Don't stay away too long.
Yeah, no, I'm talking to a loony robot who's offering to help me take over the world. I came here to find Benny and get the chip back. Okay? And apparently I just got a whole heap of new objectives. Okay, so no Benny. No Benny, alright. Oh. Fine.
Let's hit the road.
Follow. So, at least we now know what Benny is up to. So, let's go find him and have ourselves a little chat.
Hard to believe he was a rat all along.
Okay. I think we found him. Hey, Benjamin, how are you doing?
What in the goddamn?
Oh, yeah.
Let's keep this in the groove, hey? Smooth moves, smooth.
Oh, that's my middle
Hello.
Name.
Hello. The guy everyone saw going to Hello. Lucky 38, that was you? Oh, shit.
You suck at being casual. Hello, how are you? Oh, God. The jig's up, Benny. Me and Yasmin had a talk. Seems you need to work on your marksmanship. Mr. House wants the platinum chip. Hand it over. No, give me one good reason not to kill you. I like it.
You want a reason? How about four?
Four's
They're
good.
They're called bodyguards, and every one of them is packing. Me too, so baby makes five. Add to that, every chairman in this joint is armed, and not with some holdout pea shooter like maybe you smuggled through security.
Oh, pea
Anyhow,
shooter?
Baby, you didn't come here for vengeance. You came to get clued in. What say you and me cash out? Go somewhere that's more private-like. Any questions you got, I'll answer.
Yeah. Pea shooter, mate? Seriously, if you think all I've got is a pea shooter, you are in for a big surprise. What have you got in mind? He's going to try and... You know what, though? I'm curious. Wonder what he's offering. I mean, if he's trying to take over, maybe, you know. I'm going to listen to him.
To start, I'll comp you the presidential. Best suite in the house. You deserve a taste of the VIP.
Everyone's
lifestyle.
Giving me rooms.
I'll hang out down here for a while to make everything look business as usual, then come to you. Any questions you got, I'll answer. Guaranteed.
Yeah, thing is, I'm still going to need that chip, you know. Still going to need that chip. Made a deal with a man, and I'm going to stick with that deal. But if you want to talk, fine. We talk here and now. Someone's got to pay off my contract. No. I've agreed to do the job. I'm bringing that chip. We talk here and now, or I'll tell everyone my story.
Do what you gotta do, baby, and let the chips fall as they may. You know where to find me.
It ain't.
Cool by me if you want to talk after all, but a confab like this, out in public, in my place of business... That don't play.
Fine.
Like I said, we should be talking somewhere as private.
Let's go do this in private. I want the platinum chip and I want it now. Yeah, fine. Yeah, the jig's up, Benny. Me and Yes Man had a talk.
Baby, this is not the place to go talking about that.
Benny and
like
Yes
said,
Man sitting
we should be
in
talking
a tree.
Somewhere as private.
Just give me the chip and I'll stop talking about it. I want the platinum chip and I want it now.
I can't do that, baby, and you know it. There's a lot of angles to this caper. Complexities aplenty. But plenty of action, too. Enough for both of us. But we don't jabber about that out here in public.
Fine.
Like I said, we should be talking somewhere as private.
What do you have in mind?
To start, I'll comp you the presidential.
Yes,
best suite in the house.
Presidential suite. We're going... Oh, the suite's a nice touch, but someone's got to pay off my contract. Fine. Give me some money.
Where's my manners? Here's some cash up front. There'll be more where that came from. Wait for me in the presidential suite. We got a future together, you and me. It's time we got started.
I kind of like Benny, but he's annoying me now. He's got a plan. Right, we're looking for the presidential suite.
No sudden moves around the boss, got it?
How about this?
Keep those hands where I can see them.
Sudden moves, eh? You did nothing, because you know why? Because you're a wuss. Here we go. Elevator to the presidential suite. Yeah, we don't trust Benny. Okay. Again. Kind of disgusting. Mutt fruit, all right. Crunchy mutt fruit. Do you have any whiskey? Water. Really? Water? I got some whiskey. I'll take it. Okay, we'll see. I'll take that too. I probably could stop collecting ammo now. I mean, it's not really like I need a huge amount of it, but there are some things you just can't have enough of. And one of those things is ammo. Alright, well, we came in there. Completing Mark. Wait. Ring-a-ding-ding is completed. That's nice. Okay. We've completed a quest. Alright, well, where's Benny then? Alright, this is kind of fishy. And by kind of fishy, I mean really, really fishy. Keep your eyes open, guys. Oh, hello. True Police Stories, that's the... That's the one that gives you gun skills. Okay. Well, he's not here.
Baby, this little meet and greet of ours, chalk me up as a no-show. It would be 41 flavors of stupid to let you get a drop on me. And you've caused plenty enough trouble as is. You forced my hand. Hell, I gotta skip town because of you.
Oh, everyone say aw. You're a dead man. Now, at least you could do is answer some questions first. Yeah, come on.
A lifelong learner is you, eh?
That's me, Mr. Educational.
Questions count because you're lifelong is running life short.
Oh, you see, congratulations. It's been a long time coming, but I now really, really want to shoot you in the face. What's the platinum chip?
It's the house edge, baby. The key to stacking the odds in his favor. Or was, until I swiped it. There's more to it, but we don't have the time. By which I mean, you don't.
She's there with the threats again. What angle are you playing?
Angle? I'm head on, baby. Flat out. All stops pulled, full steam ahead. Side bets are for losers. I'm playing to win.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, you don't have the hand you thought you had, because you're going to die now.
That temper of yours, kind of why this conversation's taking place over an intercom. Do me a favor and stay dead this time, eh?
Yeah.
Good night, all. It's been a gas.
Okay, well, it's...
Over here!
Who else we got? Alright. Well, it seems that Benny is a good enough judge of character to understand I'm likely to shoot him. But he's not a good enough judge of person to know that wasn't going to work. Alright. Then it would seem Benny is on his way out. But the fact that these have all got keys to his suite suggests I have a feeling... I know where he is right at this minute. So, I'm thinking we should go and pay him a little visit. What do you think? Yeah, let's do that. No one seems to have cared that I have fired off a few shots. Maybe it's soundproof.
Bitter Springs. A name like that could have only brought bad luck.
Yeah, it is an unfortunate name now I think about it. Okay, guys. Guy. Cass! What is it with her? What are you? What's wrong?
I wonder where Benny went.
Fine, yes. I get it.
Let's distribute the weight.
I keep picking up the whiskey, and I'm not passing any of it on to you. Fine, I've picked up 4, have 2. I don't know. I mean, it's not like she'd run out. It really isn't. Although, you know what? All things considered, now that you mention it, I've become addicted to whiskey. I'm addicted to whiskey. I'm actually addicted to whiskey. Well, that's going to make a huge difference to my lifestyle, isn't it? All right. Benny. Where are you? Oh, yoo-hoo. You can't hide, Benny. This has been a long time coming, mate. It's time for that stand-up fight. Where's Benny? There? Dude, where's Benny?
Oh, hi again. Can I help you with something else?
You can tell me where Benny... Have you seen Benny?
Sure. He came through here in a big hurry. Didn't even stop to say hello. I think he went down his secret escape elevator out in the hall.
Secret escape... What? Secret escape elevator out in the hall? What hall? What secret elevator escape... Did we miss something? Secret escape elevator out in the hall? I don't see any elevator. I guess that's why it's a secret. Secret elevator in the hall. Okay, wrong way. Oh, no, he has not escaped. He has not escaped. What secret elevator in the hall? Here? This isn't a hall. Take elevator to sub-basement, request key, request... Is this? Oh, God. Do you have a key? Do you have a key? I need a key to the sub-basement. I need a key.
Oh, hi again. Can I help you with something else?
I need a key. A key to the sub...
Hope to see you soon.
No one told me about a sub-basement. Would you please stop smiling?
Yippee-yay. Today.